welcome to another week's summary of Inktober 2019. There, of course, is one more to come, as this year there are 5 Tuesdays in the month of October. And then I hear you say you did and posted art every day, and then the challenge is over. How do you fill the void in your days? In my case, I will continue my work on the same ACEOs into November. During November, I shall color them, experimenting with different mediums and techniques and how they work together with the different line art options I'm currently working on. After that, we are in December, and what I have termed cut red, not exclusively cut in, but heavily slanted towards it. Let's see if we can make it an art challenge as well. A cat or other pet-related illustration for each of the 4 weeks of Advent. I don't think people who for various reasons can't have cats should be excluded. And then we are in the 20s again, and the current plan is to dedicate January to the 1920s. The 1920s were a decade of much change, and with it a lot of experimentation and new movements in the arts and music, together with much change socially and politically. Plus, there are 2 videos for the AAC that one's slotting in there somehow as well. For November, the theme is going to be reptiles, so stay tuned for that one. The AAC theme after that one, you guys will have to vote on when the polls open up again. At this point, I can't even tell you whether the collective will stick to animal families or find some other challenging way to group animals. More about that when we get closer to it and we know more. For now, let me tell you a bit about the art so you patiently have been watching while I have been going on about my plans for the rest of the year. I'm back to using my little brush that I like so much at the moment. For the beaver, I use black acrylic ink. It applies very differently to the India ink you may remember from the tiger card. It is more creamy, also that is hardly surprising, but it's still liquidy enough to get smooth lines. For the duck again, I use the same method but a different color ink, called Oriental Blue. I'm looking forward to seeing how the different colors of line art affect the look when it's colored in, and I like how the perspective worked out. With the unicorn, I'm breaking from using the brush and instead use the nib pen again. The nib is the G pen again. At this point, it should be clear that it's probably my favorite nib when it comes to illustration nibs. Final cut, who has made it into the video, is a cat again. So far, we had a tiger and a sleeping cat, and there is a lion still to come if I remember the sketches correctly. Just like with the tiger, I'm using black India ink and a small brush to apply it with. It will remain to be seen how similar they will be once November is over. While it is watercolor paper, I plan on using all kinds of